Open up the gate. Let him out.
You sure he's not ready?
Go on, let him out.
He's just a man, Peter. Only another man.
A man was made by patience and the odds against him.
For what kind of man would I be if I did not help my mother? I did not save her.
Sort of a lonesome place out here, Pete. Unless you get in the swing of things.
You said that Jane has pushed you as an actor.
Mm-hmm.
I'm curious to know how.
Just in terms of my character development, my approach, you know, directors have done that for me in the past, but not to the degree that Jane did. She had me, or invited me rather, to take up, you know, a body movement specialist, to work with one, to kind of really dial in the nuances and the movements of Peter. I guess to express his delicacy in the nature of his being, and also like a dialect coach, which, you know, I've worked with many in the past. Obviously, I'm Australian. I had to dial in the American accent at some point. And I thought, I mean, I think it's pretty good at this point, but there were other levels to it that I hadn't explored, like the lisp and things like that that were in the book. And to have the guidance of Jane and to put my complete trust in her, in terms of her telling me, you know, turn the level up, you know, we need a bit more from this and that, it was hard at times, because you think, am I risking too much, am I doing too much? But of course, it's Jane, you know, you have that thought in the flash of a second. And again, like as I said, I was in a constant state of surrendering those thoughts, surrendering your ego and its defiance to experience working with a masterful filmmaker and be guided. And that's extremely rewarding.
As an actor, the creative role that you play, there's a gut that happens, an instinct that happens, an inspiration that happens, that then is moderated by intellect and technique.
Mm-hmm.
And you as a young actor are, if I may be so presumptuous to assume, finding your way through moderating between those two. Where do you think you are in that process? And do you think there's a point at which it will meld for you and you no longer?
I would say that it's not just because I'm a young actor that I'm in a constant state of moderating. I would just say that I think it's healthy to be in a constant state of moderating, to continuously be a student of your craft, of those who guide you, those who you are in admiration for, but also just in life overall. I've been doing this since I was 8 years old. You know, my father passed on all of his techniques that I, you know, carry on and lead me today. And one of the main things that he taught me was, you know, don't ever solidify anything that he passes on to me. Always be open to evolving, always. So personally, I'm not going to say it's my age that keeps me in a state of moderation or evolution. I'll always be that. I'm not ever going to get to a point where I stop and become stagnant in nature. And if anything, being challenged by Jane to go that much further only enforced that.
When you're working on a character like this one, where there's so many technical qualities that you're reaching for and achieving, how much of you just lets go and rides, and how much of you is self-observant and guiding?
Yeah, there was I remember there was just a portion in like the rehearsals and, you know, just being introduced to Jane and you know, feeling each other out a bit, creatively speaking. And as I said, you know, we all have that narrative in our head that can doubt things. If you say it's not there, then I wouldn't believe you, because it's there. And it's just a matter of how much you give it power, rather. And for me, I try to observe those thoughts, those negative or doubtful or the things that keep me in that stagnant nature that we talk about. So, I mean, I'm always observing that, and I was always observing it throughout the experience on this job. But I remember there was a point when I'd gone home after rehearsing, and I remember I had to choose, you know, as Plato calls it, there's like a Y path in philosophy where you can see yourself going down one way or the other. And I remember I had to choose, am I going to continue feeling like I'm risking something or doubting, or am I going to completely surrender to the process? And of course, I mean, to Jane as a masterful filmmaker, mm-hmm. you have to. And I did that, and I did it with great ease and enjoyment, and I found fun in that. So yeah, I think that was an important area to highlight.